Hi, I'm Mike Thompson, and this is my new Hypo chamber. I built it to pressure test my new Aqualung dive computer because I, wanted to see if it worked before I actually went to the lake and kind of messed around with it. I haven't added servos internally. I want to build a little package that the computer clips into with two servos so I can control the computer actually while it's under pressure. I haven't done that yet. That'll be a separate project. But here is my hyperbaric chamber in this case. Of course, I could also put a vacuum on this and make it a hypobaric chamber should I want to. And yes, I probably do. But a Schrader valve lets air go in from the pump. The pump has a pressure gauge on it, but as you can see here, I can use the dive computer for a much more accurate sense of pressure inside. Now, if I were testing something else, I probably wouldn't have the dive computer inside. And a nice little surprise is I was thinking I would have to flood this thing with water and then pump air into it to pressurize it. Turns out the dive computer doesn't sense water, it just senses pressure. And so it automatically turns on into dive mode once you get below 5 feet worth of pressure. Now, atmospheric pressure is about 15 psi, and an atmosphere of water is about 33 feet, or about 30 feet, so you get about 2 feet per psi. So this is made out of 4-inch PVC pipe. I've got an end cap that I drilled out the center of and then installed a 1/2-inch acrylic plate so that I could see what's going on inside there. Figure if I can't see what's going on in there, there's really no sense in building this chamber at all. And of course it's loaded on the back by a clean-out cap. Just simply unscrew that, stick in whatever I want to do, or pour in any sort of fluids, screw the cap back on, and it's good to go. But anyway, this is my hypo chamber, and it was pretty darn easy to build, really. Let me show you how I did it. So I mounted a 4-inch hole saw in my lathe chuck and drilled out the center here. This was pretty snazzy and pretty much guaranteed perfection. And back it out here. That doesn't make a good sound, that's for sure. All right, that looks pretty good. I'm happy with that. Look at that. And there's enough of a lip to hold the acrylic window. Now I'm just using the lathe here. I'm gonna clean this up a little bit, smooth that edge so it's not quite so sharp. And now I'm bandsawing out my hole. This doesn't have to be perfectly circular. It just has to be slightly smaller than the ID of the pipe. But I say I got that pretty darn circular. I'm happy with that. Now I'll take the paper off here in a second and test it. Okay, I'm gonna run a bead of silicone in there now. This PVC glue is by Christie's, and it's a blue glue, so this is not double purple primer. It's purple and blue, which is just more purple. That went on pretty good. I like that. It feels nice. Okay? Yep, like that. And I'm tapping this for an 1/8-inch NPT fitting, so I can screw in a Schrader valve, which is a tire valve. I don't remember where I got this. This has been through several pneumatic potato guns, but now I'm using it for this. Amazon probably has these. Like I said, it's 1/8-inch NPT. Now, obviously, I don't want to get purple primer up on my acrylic window, so I'm going to be extra careful with this one. I'm going to prime this first, then this, so I can do it all in kind of in one shot here. A bunch of purple primer on both, and some blue glue. Shove it on here, give it a little bit of rotation to spread that glue around. Okay. That feels, yep, that's not moving much. Okay. This blue stuff sets up pretty quick. Okay. Pressure vessel. I'll probably have to Teflon these threads here for sure. Probably for sure. Yes, that's wonderful. But there we go. Not half bad. So I've got my dive computer here in the pipe, supported by two 3D printed little pieces there that form an X. Screwed this end cap on. And yes, Teflon was required on the threads. And you can see here I'll hook up my air pump. It's on surface mode right now, and we'll start to add pressure. And as soon as you get below 5 feet of pressure, it activates dive mode. Pretty cool, huh? And to speed it up here, we'll just take her on down. Let's say, we'll go at least 100. Yep, there. 120, can we get 121? It sure gets hard to pump. And this is about 60 PSI, according to the pump. And the dive computer agrees. So on the main dive screen here, it shows your depth in white, your no deco time remaining at that depth of 8 minutes. Maximum depth this dive was 121, and I've been diving for just 4 minutes. Down at the bottom there, I've got gas one, which is air. My battery life is good. The green bar on the left over there is my ascent rate graph. So now I'm letting some air out here for ascent, and you can see it screams at me that I'm coming up too fast. When you get within 5 feet of your safety stop, it's going to alert you right there. Safety stop at 15 feet for 3 minutes. I guess when I'm taking a video of a video, certain parts of my screen kind of don't show up. That's interesting. Of course, it could be the light reflecting off the surfaces here. I don't know. 20 seconds to go at my safety stop. Okay, let's finish our ascent. You can see the ascent rate graph on the left. Oh, too fast. And that's that. We are on the surface. Now this thing, despite all the purple primer, caulking, PVC cement, it had a few pinhole leaks. And so we took the Schrader valve out. Alex hooked up his pump in reverse so that it vacuumed through the hose barb we put in place of the Schrader valve. We put thin super glue along the joints here in the PVC where the leaks were, as shown by the bubble test, and sucking the glue into the joints sealed them up quite nicely. Well, there you go. That's something you can definitely do yourself should you want to. I can think of all sorts of uses for this offhand, and those will probably be featured in a forthcoming video. But go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already. I'm Mike Thompson, and thanks for watching. I really appreciate it.